Hello, so this is going to be a video on different styles of bayonets because I had some people asking me questions about, you know, how bayonets vary. Now, I'll do the legal caveat bit at the very beginning of this video, and that's in the UK you can pretty much own any type of bayonet in your house, but obviously you can't threaten people with them or do anything stupid like that, or just randomly wander around with a bayonet on you in the street or something like that. But for owning in your house, they're perfectly legal. So we've got three examples of bayonet here. We've got the Lee Enfield Spike bayonet, I think it's called Number 4 Mark 1 Spike. We've got the VZ58 bayonet, although the end has been reprofiled by me slightly on this one because it was sort of slightly snapped off the one I got. And your standard old AKM style bayonet for Kalashnikovs. So, obviously, what this is, that's these German one anyway, it should hopefully show you the different styles of bayonets. Now obviously there's way more different bayonet styles than this, but these are kind of, I think, the three archetypes a lot of them fall into. A spike design, and I believe the spike was actually outlawed at one point because it was considered to be too inhumane. You know, I always find that a bit strange when you've got devices that are designed to stab people to death, but some types of blades are too inhumane. It doesn't make much sense to me, but anyway. So, for a very long time, if you think of the musket period, most bayonets were kind of this spike design. The idea being kind of they had a collar lock normally onto the very end of the rifle, and then it was just a long spike. Now obviously the purpose of a bayonet is to stab infantry or cavalry, sort of, you know, charging you, so horses or men. If you had to use your rifle or whatever in a close quarters situation where you couldn't shoot it. Then this is kind of the other types of bayonet design you see quite a lot, which is where it looks more like kind of a straight dagger, but it's, you know, so you could call it a very short sword, I guess. This one is the VZ58 one, but these are, you know, you find with later design bayonets as well, they normally have quite a simple locking lug to go onto the rifle that's just held in place of a button like that. But, you know, bayonets like that, sometimes they could be sharp, sometimes they couldn't. In general, bayonets weren't sharp, and the reason for that was if you stabbed a horse or a person with a bayonet, if it had a sharp edge on it, and it had one of these type designs, it could actually get caught in the ribs and not come out cleanly, because the whole point of a bayonet, especially of like that spike design, is that you basically puncture it in and pull it out straight away. So the idea is it hits a vital organ, perforates it, and then, you know, the person bleeds out or dies, and you can pull it out easily. But you sort of see quite a lot of bayonets like this. Some Enfield bayonets have this sort of design. You know, lots of nations use this kind of design, but this is the kind of design you see a lot on World War I, World War II bayonets, if they weren't the spike design. In general, spike designs were cheaper, but these are a lot more practical, obviously, because if you were using it for hand-to-hand fighting as well, you could actually do it with a knife like this. You'd struggle with that. Though, interestingly, somebody did show me a picture where you could buy those, where they'd actually put a handle, like a straight handle on them, not to use as a bayonet anymore, but to use as a knife, which was quite strange. But yeah, so obviously, these were the bayonets that were kind of designed to be, you know, you could use them in hand-to-hand fighting, or you could use them, you know, on a rifle for its thrusting spear sort of design. And then you get things like the AK bayonets, which are kind of still designed to be a bayonet, but they're basically more of a utility knife, where basically often soldiers would sharpen this edge, and then you've got the bit on there for putting in to use with a wire cutter. So if we put that on there like that, it's this way around, isn't it? There we go, yep. What you would do is have the bayonet like that, and then you'd use that to cut wire with the sheath. Quite a few bayonets, modern ones, use that design, but you never really seem to see that on older bayonets. It's more of an innovative thing. So the AK bayonet is obviously designed, yes, you can still thrust with it, but the idea is, because it's got a ridge back, you know, you can have that edge sharpened or not sharpened. The idea of an AK bayonet was more, you know, to be utilitarian. So it could just be used as a utility knife, or it could be stuck on the end of the rifle if you thought you might have to stab with it. Obviously, the disadvantage is when you turn it more into an all-round utility knife, it's not quite as good as stabbing aerodynamically on a rifle. But it probably ends up being a lot more practical, because the probability that bayonets are actually going to be used in modern warfare for their design is very low. You know, with automatic rifles, automatic machine guns, everything like that, artillery. They were much more, I think, from an age, like we said, of muskets, where the rate of fire on the guns was much lower and the accuracy was much lower. But hopefully this has given you a good idea of how the sort of designs vary. Now, there's probably some really more weird designs I don't even know of, but as I said, with all the bayonets I've got, they always seem to fall into these categories. They always seem to be a spike-type design, sort of a double-edged style design, whether it's blunt or sharp, which is basically you know, what you could think of a sword or a dagger. And then you've got your kind of just utility knife that fits onto a rifle through a mounting system. But the really annoying thing for me, all the deactivated guns and obsolete caliber guns I've got, none of them I have any of the proper bayonets for. So the closest I have is the AKM and AK-74 bayonets I've got. And I can put those on the deactivated RPK, but the issue is the RPK doesn't have the locking lugs for the bayonet, so the bayonet goes on, but it won't stay on there tight, so if you thrust it, the knife would just fly off. But there you go. Hopefully you found that interesting. So most bayonets with nations that are still issuing them now, unless they're like a ceremonial thing, always seem to be like the AK-style bayonets, where, you know, they're kind of designed more for a multi-purpose utility knife, which just can snap onto the rifle as one of its utilities, rather than it being, you know, a thing purposely for stabbing people. And obviously, that's literally all you could do with something like that. That could probably be used in hand-to-hand combat or for, you know, attaching to a rifle. But for the most part, you know, everybody now, you know, I suppose you could say, thankfully, uses a design which is designed really that it's never going to be stabbed into a person. It may do that as a last resort, but it's mostly as a utility thing. Which is always strange when you see, like, where Mike's got that Chinese Type 86S rifle. It's always strange when you see the bayonet on that doesn't have the wire cutter on. It's this exact bayonet design, but without the wire cutter. Anyway, hopefully for the people asking about bayonets, you found that useful. And just as, you know, another disclaimer again, in the UK, I'm not aware of any bayonets you're not allowed to own in your own home, because bayonets don't really fall into the sort of certain kinds of band knives in the UK, but you can't go wandering around with them out, you know, on you in a public place, because obviously you have no reason to be carrying a knife like that. That's the law. But for a personal collection in your house, you know, as long as you're not threatening anybody with them or doing anything stupid with them, there's no rules against them. They're nice little collectibles from history, you know, and just they are what they are.